Hi guys, this is Utkarsh Jain today and we have another interesting video on CFA code and ethics on the StoryLine. So we have an investment bank and the analysts of this investment bank today are sitting and debating about how to make an excellent performance presentation report which will be used to acquire new clients. So they have made a list of the investment accounts they've had over the period of last 10 years and these are those accounts. Now the red ones that you see here are the accounts where the firm has made losses and therefore the clients have left. So what the analyst decides to do is to remove all the accounts where the firm has made losses and only use the ones where the firm have made profit and make an excellent performance presentation report. Now here is Ross. Ross is the head of the sales team of this firm. He is a CFA candidate and the analyst or the team has asked Ross to use this report and get them some money, right? So make use of this report, pitch it to the new clients and get them some money. Now Ross knows about the miscalculation or misrepresentation in the report. However, this is what he thinks. He thinks that since I am not directly involved in making the report, I'm covered. I don't have to worry about it, right? Now, here is a new client with whom Ross is having a meeting and he's wanting to convert this client and get his investment account. So Ross starts explaining him the investment process of the firm. He explains what is the rationale for firm to pick up investments. And finally, to convince the client, he makes use of this particular report. And now the client is convinced. So he's agreed to pay the check or write the check today and give pass on his account to Ross's investment advisory. Now the question is, has Ross committed a violation of code and standards? And the answer is yes. So here is our CFA guru who's going to help Ross understand what went wrong. So here is what Guru has to say. Guru says misrepresentation of performance is a violation of code and standards. So here is what Ross replies. Ross says, yes, but I am not the one who's calculated these results. So now the Guru says, you're right, but using the report with the knowledge that there was a misrepresentation is a violation of standard 1A. So then Ross says, I had no choice, they forced me. What could I have done? So here is what Guru has to say. Step number one, you should have disassociated yourself from the activity. You should not have used the report. Step number two, you should have persuaded the team to revise the report and add disclosures and also add those accounts which have been intentionally left out. Third, you should have brought this to the notice of the supervisor and the compliance team. And four, that if you were forced to still use the report, then please go and visit www.findmeanewjob.com. Alright guys, so this is Utkarsh Jain. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you very much. I'll see you in the next one.